Good morning, children. In the last class, we have learned journey of food from mouth till liver. Yes, today we'll learn about complete digestion of food till anus. Okay, we will start with the pancreas first. Let's learn what are pancreas. Children, in the picture below the liver, you can see the pancreas. Yes. The pancreas is about 6 inches long. It is 6 inches long and it is present across the back of the abdomen and it is present behind the stomach. Okay. It is present behind the stomach and its head is on the right side of the abdomen. In the picture, you can see in the pancreas that there is a small tube-like structure which looks like roots, okay, and these are called as pancreatic duct. It is connected to the duodenum. The pancreatic duct is connected to the duodenum, okay. And the function of these pancreas to produce the digestive juices or it produce enzymes. And these enzymes help in the digestion of food. And the enzymes produced by the pancreas are released into the small intestine. These are released into the small intestine for the digestion of food. These enzymes help in the digestion of food. And this pancreas also produces insulin. Insulin is a hormone. It is a hormone and it controls the sugar level in our body. Around 1.5 liters of pancreatic juice is produced in each day. In each day, 1.5 liters of pancreatic juice or digestive enzymes are produced by pancreas. And if these pancreas do not produce these digestive enzymes, then, or these enzymes do not produce insulin, then we get diabetes. When food leaves from the stomach, it enters into the small intestine. This small intestine is nearly 7 meters long coiled tube. It is 7 meters long and it is a coiled tube. It is present below the abdomen and it is very long coiled tube. If we remove 1/3 of the small intestine also, and the body can still function. When the food enters into the small intestine, then pancreas will send the enzymes produced by it. With the help of these enzymes, the food is again get digested. And the process of digestion completes in the small intestine only. Here in the small intestine, the food is digested into the soluble substance. And this soluble substance is absorbed by the walls of the small intestine. And then it is passed into the bloodstream. The remained food is then passed from small intestine to the large intestine. Large intestine is a long and wide tube that is tightly coiled by the small intestine. It is a long tube which is coiled by a small intestine and it is the end of the digestive system. It receives the remains of food from the small intestine. The excess of water, salts are absorbed by the large intestine. When the remained food is passed from the small intestine to large intestine, then the large intestine will absorb the excess of water, salts, okay, from the remained food. This large intestine is along 1.5 meters long tube it is. The undigested food stays in the large intestine for up to 12 hours. It stays in the large intestine for about 12 hours before it is passed out from the body. The waste products and the fibers which are not digestible, these are passed to the end of the digestive tract. The walls of the large intestine produces a slime mucus. This mucus help the food waste to slide down along easily and pass out from the body through the anus. The food waste is called as feces. Food waste is passed from the body through the anus. Before the waste is passed out from the anus, the waste product enters into the rectum first. Then the rectum is a tube-like structure and it is the end of the large intestine. This rectum holds the waste till it is passed out from the body. When this fills up, we feel to go to toilet, and the opening of the body is called anus, and it is the end of the rectum. The solid waste passes out from the anus, and here we have finished the journey of food from mouth to anus. Okay, thank you. Open page number 72. There is one activity. You need to complete this activity. See the activity, what it is. Give a star to each child who follows healthy eating habit. Here in the book, they have given some images in page number 72 and 73. Okay. What you need to do? You need to watch the pictures, and if they are following the healthy eating habits, then you need to give the star for them. Okay. Complete this activity and send. Okay. Thank you.